Joining us live now on that note is our resident political analyst, Joe Siracusa, Curtin's Professor of Global Futures. So this all comes on a day, Joe, this morning, and I suppose this is becoming a little less shocking now. A potential possible third assassination attempt was thwarted by police in California over the weekend.
Yes, Pete, good morning. Look, the President of the United States is always open season for anybody who wants to take a shot at him. You know, America has 500 million registered guns and rifles, so, you know, what could possibly go wrong? They got some guy today who was carrying live ammunition and had his an extra magazine clip, and he had a phony VIP pass and entry into where the president was, so they put two and two together, arrested him. On the other hand, they let him go on a $5,000 bond. So, you know, they didn't have him cold, but the point is they're sort of circling. Now, look, today's really big news, Pete. The United States has directly involved itself in the war in the Middle East by deploying that anti-air system, and they're going to send 100 troops.
Yeah.
And, of course,
boots on the ground, is that, Joe?
Well, this is the first time in the history of Israeli-American relations. Every American president in my lifetime, including President Reagan and President Eisenhower, avoided this kind of thing. What it tells us is this, Pete. It tells us that Israel is on the ropes here and that President Biden is going to pull out all stops while he is president of the United States. What it also tells me is that, I don't think this is a secret among people in your business. I think the internal polling among the Democrats has told them that Kamala Harris has lost the presidency. She's not going to win. You know, when she got the lucky draw a couple months ago, 28% of the American people thought that Biden was going in the wrong direction. And she says that there's no separation between her and Biden. So people have woken up. And I think Trump is sort of planning his return. This idea that I think President Biden is pulling out all stops to help his allies, that is, you know, both Ukraine and Israel, before they lose the election is the intended. But for a guy who wanted to stay away from the forever wars, he's got himself a beauty, Pete.
Yeah, well, yeah. And just on that note, there's some breaking news. This is courtesy of our colleagues at Sky News in the UK. Four people are now dead, Joe, when it comes to this squadron of drones attack in northern Israel this morning in a town called Binyamina. As many as 61 have been injured. So at this point, four dead, 61 injured. That's probably going to fluctuate a fair bit, as these things tend to do. But what do you make of that kind of effort? I mean, it was a breach through the Iron Dome system that these drones were able to get past.
No system, Pete, is 100%, including the one that President Reagan had hoped for with the Space Defense System. It's not complete. So things are going to get through. And, of course, Hezbollah and the Iranians have realized that if you swamp the system, things are going to get through. Look, this is going to get worse before it gets better. And I think the Israelis are going to respond very vigorously to this. You know, as soon as you start to draw blood on Israeli soil, the Israelis are taking a different approach.
Yeah.
And keep in mind, I think about 87% of the Israelis agree with Netanyahu on what he should do with Iran. So it's not like he's a broken politician here. He's got a mandate to do what he wants. But I think Israel's a little bit on the ropes. I think Biden is trying to rescue them at the last minute. And I think Kamala Harris should be looking for her next job.
All right. We'll see. Joe, we're out of time, but always good to chat to you. We'll talk to you again soon.